I am Dr. Pauline Shanti, working as Assistant Professor in the Department of Anatomy, Christian Medical College, Vellore, India. The title of our study is Comparison of CT Numbers of Organs Before and After Plastination Using the Standard S10 Technique. Plastination, invented by Gunther von Hagens in the year 1977, has established itself as an indispensable contributor to the teaching armamentarium of clinical anatomists. It is the process where water and lipids in biological tissues are replaced with curable polymers like silicone, epoxy, or polyester. Specimens thus preserved are called plastinates. They are dry, odorless, and retain their appearance prior to preservation down to the microscopic level. The aim of this study was to make plastinates from cadavers using standard S10 plastination technique and to compare the radiological tissue properties before and after plastination to see the suitability of using plastinates as phantom for treatment planning in radiotherapy. So, for this purpose, we obtained two specimens, an above diaphragm specimen from a male cadaver and a below diaphragm specimen from a female cadaver. These specimens were plastinated using the standard S10 plastination technique by fixation, dehydration, forced impregnation and gas curing. CT imaging of the specimens were done before and after plastination. The images of pre-plastinate and post-plastinate were then compared for anatomical accuracy, volume of organs and CT numbers in Hounsfield units on a treatment planning system called Varian Eclipse Medical Systems in the Department of Radiotherapy, as seen here. Anatomical accuracy of the plastinet was confirmed by comparing CT images on a slice-by-slice basis. As you see here, the plastinet showed better image quality and tissue differentiation than the pre-plastinet. Volume estimation was done by contouring the organ from the cranial end to the caudal end in all the slices of the CT images. This was further confirmed by 3D reconstructed volumes. There was an average shrinkage of 25% of all the organs, though it was not much in parenchymatous organs like thyroid, parotid, kidney, liver, etc., as seen in this graph. Up to 10% of shrinkage in plastination is unavoidable. Different methods have been used by various authors to quantify the shrinkage, like fluid displacement, morphometrics on scanned images, computer-assisted morphometry, etc. Our method of volume estimation could probably be more accurate than these methods, which accounts for the excessive shrinkage. The CT numbers of tissues were obtained by taking an average of 5 CT numbers in different places within the same organ. CT numbers were uniformly increased in all tissues in the post-plastinate. But this was minimal in bone and air-filled sinuses, as seen in this graph. The silicone in the tissues has increased the tissue density, which has further increased the CT numbers. Plastination preserves the morphology of parent tissue very well and gives accurate anatomical details. It yields specimens that closely represent the in vivo anatomy. Plastinates are stable over time and ensures repeatability and reproducibility. They have been used with different diagnostic imaging methodologies that see anatomy from a new and different perspective. Because of these properties, we were considering the possibility of using plastinates as phantom for treatment planning in radiotherapy. Phantoms are structures made of one or more tissue substitutes used to simulate radiation interactions in the human body. The Allison Brando Phantom is currently used widely for radiation dosimetry. This is a section of the Allison Brando Phantom. This shows that the Brando Phantom is made of bone and soft tissue and also lung substitutes, but it has no organs in it. On the other hand, the plastinated phantom has all the organs in it. This is a section of a plastinated phantom which shows all the organs intact. Since the plastinated phantom has all the organs intact, it overcomes the disadvantage of the Brando phantom. But the results of this study shows that plastination using standard S10 technique is not ideal to replace the Brando phantom. Modification of the standard S10 technique is needed for this purpose. Thank you.